Yes, yes, and yes. The 1976 Chevy Sport Stepside Pickup, four-wheel drive from Revell USA. 102 parts in 1/24th scale. This beauty is, let's take a look at all the stuff in the box. We've got this beautiful new decal sheet. Let's get a closer look. Look at all the stuff on there to make our lives a lot easier. Full complement of dash decals. The whole kit and caboodle. Even has the cab surround in silver around the back. Don't even have to paint that on. We've got our seat belts. We've got our striping, our box wood down in there. We've even got, for the fuel can, underhood markings, marker lights, bow tie for the grill, everything. Even the tailgate lettering is done. Excellent decal sheet. These things are saving me a lot of build time. Also in the box, nice set of clear parts. Make note, a sunroof option, back glass, windshield, and headlights. So we do have that sunroof option. We've got some no-name off-road tires. They look nice. They got the zigzag pattern. Definitely typical of the 70s bias plies. These are solid core tires. Remember that when you do your assembly, that they won't slide over the rims easily unless you do the rims in two parts. We'll get a whole bunch of white styrene out here. Let's get it all piled up. While you're staring at that big pile for a second, we'll sneak in the chrome tree. We got our bumpers, we got a CB antenna, floor shifters, valve covers. We got our California or towing mirrors. Check out those Chevy wheels on there. Just beautiful, look exactly like the real thing. We'll have to dull coat those, get that chrome shine off those, and that nice square body grille. Let's check out the parts. We've got our step side bed here. Excellent molding, got those nice squared off shapes. We got our tailgate, we have an optional spare tire mount, roll bar, we've even got bed chains to hold the tailgate, and we've got our molded in bed with full detail that we'll be able to use those decals on. We've got our rear differential and front differential all in one piece with their springs. We got the wheel backs there. We've even got the steering link all molded in, makes for quick, easy, non-fiddly assembly. We've got our frame molded together with our dual exhaust integrated. You'll want to paint your frame and then paint your gas tanks and your exhaust by hand painting, or you can mask it off if you so desire. I will likely do it by hand. Gives me a little bit of time to zen out and enjoy it. They're running the dual shock system on the front and the rear for a total of 8 shocks. We got our belts and pulleys. We've got the full steering column with turn signal and automatic shifter. We've got a skid plate, a brush guard. We've got our manifolds into our exhaust. We've got an optional fuel tank. Cylinder heads and valve covers. There's our transfer case. Here's either side of the engine and transmission combination. Here is the yummy Chevy dashboards from the 80s. I really like them. And those decals are going to bring out everything for us that we saw on there. We've got some more sway bar mounts that'll mount in nicely. We've got some supports for the front and rear differentials. We've got the back of the cab. We've got the giant square body hood on that thing. We've got our optional spare tire and cover. And we've got our interior tub. You can see there, those decals are going to help out a lot when we have that interior tub in there. Nice bench seat with a molded in pedal. So we're all set, and then the bell of the ball, that square body cab, is an absolute stunner. We've got the battery molded underneath. It's got a dual battery setup. Must be an old military truck. We've got our reservoirs on either side, and we are all set to go. We've got those nice thin vent windows and the back of our cab. And underneath, it is cut out, if you so desire, to cut out that sunroof. All right, folks, we know the drill. Simple green to rinse off any mold release so my paint doesn't fisheye. Then I will start doing sub-assemblies and we will be back to take a look at that. Everything goes together real simply. We've got that 350 all set, 350, 305, I'm just going to say 350, all set to go. The intake is all one piece with the distributor. There is no carburetor because the air cleaner just goes right down on top, so that molds in and you wouldn't be able to see it anyway, so they do not include one in this particular version of the kit. But that is a nice looking small block. and I'll easily be able to paint those well-done manifolds and exhaust pipes separately. I like to glue them together with model glue because they hold much tighter. On that air cleaner, you can see that that just goes right down into that intake and it'll sit over the top. We're not going to see any sort of carburation. I cut these shocks free. I want to do those colored just because I want them to stand out a little bit with the black frame. The frame is all set to go. You just cut it free and I'll be able to paint that up black, and then I'll be able to hand paint the exhaust and the fuel tanks. I did not mount the suspension in because the drive shafts are already on there. That'll make it a little too hard to get in with the transfer case and the engine. We'll wait till everything's painted, then slowly assemble it with super glue. The transfer case is all set to go. We'll just stick that on a toothpick and get that all sprayed up in aluminum or bare metal color like it would have been on the real one. The spare tire is all glued together. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to be using this on the mount like they said, or if I'm going to set it in the box, or what I'm going to do with it, but I did want to assemble it, so if I change my mind, I could do so at any point. The belt, pulley, and alternator assembly is all done. That's three pieces. That's all glued together. That will be painted basic black. It's a General Motors. It's not going to be fancy. We got the fuel tank that will definitely be used. We'll definitely be putting that in the box. We'll look at the box in just a second. The rear differential is all set on its own with its brace across the bottom. So that's all ready to go. We'll be painting that up. The radiator and its surround is separate from the engine bay. So we'll be painting that up. That will be inserted later like they want you to. So you just have to install that surround on there. That works lovely. The wheel backs, I glue mine solidly together. You can leave them loose so that you can spin your wheels and let your car roll off your shelf. I glue mine together all the time because I don't want it rolling anywhere once I'm done building it. Now, because those are solid tires, those are completely solid, like I had said before, we'll paint them and then push the wheels in from both sides, and the friction will hold them more than tight enough. If you try to glue the tire and the wheel together and shove them through a solid tire, a hollow tire will flex, you can snap it right over the top. A solid rubber tire like this could give you a lot of problems. It could be bust the rim, the bead right off the rim, so you don't want to do that with these. It's much safer to just go ahead and do it in two pieces, paint them up, push them together later. The front differential has its brace glued on, and we've got our radiator hose there, so that's ready for paint. I've done the steering wheel because I want to get that painted. I don't want that to be chrome. And then we will have that ready to go with its shifter on there. The cab is ready to paint. Now, it's not actually glued together. I just press fit it together for you to see. We've got that nice big slab hood on there. We've got the back pressed in. The back can't be put until the interior's in because the way the body rolls down at the bottom here, you'll never be able to get your wider interior inside. You could see the fit without any glue on it on the back is very, very nice. So we know with confidence we'll be able to paint that and super glue it in later. But you just pull that out, and then your interior during final assembly will be going right on in, and then you'll be able to put your back on. And of course, this will hold in place once the dashboard's on. We'll put a little tab of glue on it. It's got little stopping points there and there. You can see the little nib there. So that will hold the interior in. We'll glue that into place. Then we'll put this in the back, and we'll touch it from the back side underneath with a little bit of super glue once we're ready to go. So we've got that all set. We'll be able to paint those up. We've got the box done. That is assembled from the floor, two sides, two fenders, and the tailgate. I've just finished the roll bar in the back. I definitely want to have that. I still haven't decided if I'm going to have the brush guard, but I'm definitely going to have the roll bar with the KC daylighters on the top of it. So that is all set to go. It's a little wonky right now because it's drying, but that is all set to go. You just have to drill out those holes with a 1.4 millimeter drill bit, and they will fit lovely. Now, I've left the tailgate loose so that when I get the decals in there, I'll be able to lay those wood stripe decals in there flat and not have to worry about it, and then we can close that tailgate up and I'll never touch it again. But the bed glues together very easily. First, you'll glue your main sides on, your steel sides. Then you'll glue your fenders on. Make sure you put your steps towards the front of the box. Put your reflectors towards the back of the box. And then you have some nice locating points inside the bottom. You can see those little nibs, and you can see the little locating mounts here in the center to glue all your parts together to make sure that when you're done, the box is nice and square and sits flat. You won't have any problems. So I am going to start getting everything into paint. As always, come on over to the paint booth area and let's get some spray going. Out of the paint process and things look awesome. We can check out those cool shocks I got on there. Those are gonna look great on the frame. I've got the axles and their supports all painted in a gloss black just so they stand out a little bit against our flat black frame. I have to paint the tanks a metallic color and the exhaust. You can see where I held onto the exhaust with one of my clips. Doesn't matter if it got any black paint on it because I'll be painting over it. Then I can mount the engine, transmission, and transfer case all in there and be done with the most part for the frame. Mount those sway bars on there and we are all set to go on that package. I have flat coated the chrome, which makes it look more like the satiny type stamped metal they used for the grill and whatnot. I'll be blacking out the inside of the grill. We'll be putting our headlights in, tinting with Tamiya Clear on the grill, and then I'll be coloring in the bow tie, or I'll use the decal on the sheet, whatever I prefer. Either one of them will work lovely. You can use any matte clear to do those wheels. I've got the wheel backs all set. Those are set to press into the tires. Once I get the wheels, I will paint the inside with a silver, black wash it. Then I will take a Q-tip, and the clear will come off the chrome pretty easy. If you just dip it in a little bit of thinner and rub it around the edge, we'll get that nice chrome trim ring right back. It's an easy step. The cab and the body look awesome in that dark copper metallic. I saw this weekend The Great Outdoors, an excellent Dan Aykroyd, John Candy movie. And when they're at the A&W, if you catch that scene, there is a Silverado sitting in the background with this exact cab and very close color on it. So I thought that was kind of cool that I happened to see it the same weekend I'm building the truck. I've got the engine, transmission, and exhaust painted. Just have to do the manifolds, the distributor, and the starter, and that's ready to go. That doesn't take long. We've got our beautiful fuel tank here, misted with the red. Didn't paint the bottom because that's where I glue it on. And then that will be painted with the strap on there, whatever color. We've got our roll bar and our brush bar all set up with that nice gloss white. If I decide to use the brush bar, I'm using the roll bar for sure. I painted the skid plate a metallic color just in case I decide to use it. I'm not going to put the winch in it, but I might use the skid plate. Maybe he ordered the skid plate as an option. We've got our belts and pulley system all painted. I'll be doing the back of the alternator in silver so it stands out a little bit. Our spare tire looks great with that cover. Looks like it's covered in the same kind of color as the interior, and that works for me. So I might be using that spare tire carrier. I want to get it painted anyways. Even if I don't use it on this build, I might use it for something else. And it's pre-painted in a neutral color, I could use it. The dashboard looks lovely. All that's going to need is decal work at this point, and that's done. So that's fantastic. I love it. Did the same with the steering wheel. We'll just have to pick out some silver detail on it. And we're all done with that. And wrapping up the post-paint section, we've got the interior and the seat masked off. That looks lovely. The seat, the interior panels will be covered with decals, so that's why they're smooth and they're ready to go. And our carpeting looks lovely under there. I'm going to start assembling things. When I get the chassis all assembled with its engine, the transmission, the driveline all installed, the engine painted, we'll do the trim around the cab. I'll do the interior of the fenders, a nice black color. Not sure if I'll mask and repaint. We will get this all done. One thing I do want to bring up to you guys about this Krylon Fusion, this plastic paint that I used. You can see right now it's a satiny color. It needs clear coat. I'm going to end up having to do multiple coats of future on this. What I found out was the Fusion paint, the Krylon Fusion that I used on this, I tried to clear it with, of course, a Krylon clear. Just a gloss clear. It says it's an acrylic gloss. Sprayed it over the top of that Fusion, and within 5 seconds, all the paint started to peel off as if you had done the crinkle rust effect. It just crinkled and pulled back and ruined the whole paint job on every surface. So I had to strip them and super clean overnight, super clean the purple degreaser overnight, and the paint just fell off the next day. But I reprimed them, repainted them, got them back in that beautiful copper, and I'm not going to touch it with anything more harsh than future floor polish on all these parts to get my gloss later. But I'm going to do my trim work. I can put my glass in. That's the beautiful thing about floor polishes. We can do all of our trim work. We can do the bed decals. We can do the bed chrome strips. We can do anything we want. And when we got the glass in and everything is secure, then we can go ahead and put our future on. It will not harm anything. It's as gentle as a baby kitten. So I'm going to get to work. We will come back for an update in a little bit. So far, absolutely zero issues to bring up about assembly or fit or any problems. As you can see, it is starting to turn out really super nice. First up, look at that dashboard. Holy cow, is that nice looking. There's no paint in that except for the main dark leather color. It's just all decals from Revell. Gauges, we got vents, we got radio. Oh, it just looks wonderful. We've got the logo on the side with the vents, the fake wood grain. That is an absolutely awesome looking dashboard for a model vehicle. The steering wheel comes out the same way with just a little bit of paint detail. It's got that Chevy logo in it, so that looks lovely. And then I painted the automatic shifter there. We've got the back glass in the back of the truck with the black rubber surround. We've got the extra gas tank painted up. That's ready to go. We've got the grill painted. All I need to do is the yellow accent marker lights, the turn signals, but the headlights are in. The grill is painted and the decal is on, and that's going to look awesome-tastic. The interior is done with all the belts. The four-wheel drive shift lever is in place, and the door panel decals have been applied. It looks fantastic. That's going to be awesome once I get the dashboard on top of there. We've even got kind of the spare tire just so I can keep looking at it and decide if I want to use it. We got that all set up. Now all I would do after I attach this is hang the fuel tank there. Otherwise I can always put the fuel tank in the box. Speaking of the box, is that sweet or what? Do you see that texture in the bottom? That's when I used a little bit of Tamiya MarkFit decal solvent on the wood panel decals. They went down so nice, they actually soaked in to the wood grain accents in the molded plastic. That couldn't look more beautiful if you tried. The strips are done with a Molotow chrome pen. Then the decals were laid over the top. So any mistakes you made with the chrome pen didn't make a difference because the decals covered everything. Would I love to see that in every single wood box kit? Oh, you bet I would. Absolutely awesome. The cab, I've painted the interior of the fenders black. I've got the radiator mount in there. I've got the windshield in with its black surround. We've got the door handles done. That's going to be ready to go. Once I stop talking to you guys, I will glue the steering wheel into place, push the interior up in, and then we'll put the back on the cab, and that's going to be all set to go as well. The chassis looks wonderful. No issues at all with fit, finish, or assembly. We've got our beautiful dual shock system, front and rear. We've got that 350. We've got the exhaust painted up. We got the sway bars in place. I even decided to use the skid plate in its new silver look. We've got that lovely small block under the hood, ready to go, ready to drive this truck. We've got our transfer case in place, and I like the difference in tone with the gloss black driveline. So that looks absolutely awesome, and everything lines up, and it looks spectacular. So real easy assembly so far. Things I have left to do: I've got to put the interior in the cab. I've got to get the cab on there. I've got to get the box on there. I've got to do my roll bar and its lights. So everything assembled from here. These are the beautiful wheels and tire package. Check that out with a little bit of silver paint and a little bit of black wash. That is just stock beauty. I love those wheels on those trucks. Reminds me of the rally wheels that Mopars used to have. Very similar design, but wider for a pickup truck. They look wonderful, and they just press together, so we didn't have any problems at all. We're going to be a wonderful tire package on that truck. So I'm going to get just the little final stuff together, put the interior in, put the roll bar together, get the decals on. When I come back, we will have that beautiful final. Are you ready? Because here it is, this gorgeous 76 Chevy Sport Stepside 4x4 from the peeps at Revell USA. An awesome reissue. Thanks for bringing this one back out. 1/24th scale will fit good with any other kits out there. 1/24th, 1/25th, it's not a big deal. It's an absolutely stunning kit. From the decals in the bed, look how it makes that look, just amazing. I did decide to put the accessories on the back. They're in the kit, they look great, they're molded well, and they attach easy. Why not use them? The only bummer about putting them on the back is it covers up those nice decals on the box and that say Chevrolet, which are all individual letters, and then it's got a ring of white around that as well. But it looks great, and it's on there. You can leave it off of yours. There are no holes to fill. It just loosely sits on the side. We've got our bed chains on the back as well underneath. And if you decided, if you attach it with small enough amount of CA glue, just pop it right off and no one will ever notice. But otherwise, what a joy. Easy assembly, fits great. You saw that chassis, you saw that delicious engine. In the slideshow at the end, we'll have some pictures under the hood as well. But yeah, what a beautiful Chevy kit. No problems at all. I love that copper that I use, that dark copper. Looks like the same tone that was on the one on the Great Outdoors. That truck, of course, has the same cab and front end, but it had a camper on the back, but there's still the beautiful square body. If I ever built this truck again, and I have another copy of this, so I might, I would paint it in a metallic blue, and order some side stripes for it and put the GMC grill from the Big Game Country truck on the front end instead. And I would have myself John Baker's truck from Chips. And that was a gorgeous step side as well, with the roll bar and the brush guard, so you could use all the parts from this kit. You're not going to have any problems putting it together. You're not going to have any problems with the decals either. On the new Revell decals, you do need to know, and I've mentioned this numerous times, when you soak the larger decals, the longer stripes, the bed pieces, anything that's bigger than about an inch long, you're going to want to let it soak in warm to mildly hot water for 3 to 4 minutes, and it will release much easier for you. If you soak it in cold water, it's going to take quite a long time to release, and it also might not want to release for 10-15 minutes in cold water. These decals are well made. They don't rip. They allow you to adjust them for quite a while. They adapt to decal solvents to conform to the curves quite well without issue. I see that there are still some very minor wrinkles on some of the compound curves on mine, and while it is still drying the decals, within about 24 hours that decal solvent will nestle them down. I've had that happen before with other vehicles, and within 24 hours they go back to perfect. So don't worry if you see a couple wrinkles, leave them alone, put your decal solvent on it. I like to use Tamiya Mark Fit, and you're not going to have a problem. Buy this kit now. It's a hot seller before it goes out of stock. There will be a link where to pick this up right now from the folks at Model Roundup. I thank Revell USA for this copy, and we will see you at the next review. Make sure, stay positive, have fun, and build your models your way that make you smile. Don't build for anyone else. We'll see you on the next review on HBI Guys Workshop.